In this illustration, we'll discuss about a block at rest on vertical surface of another block. Here we are given that a horizontal force F is applied on a block A supported on rough vertical surface of block B, and it is resting on a rough horizontal surface. Now, it is saying if friction coefficient between all surfaces in contact is mu, we are required to find a minimum value of F for which there is no sliding between the blocks A and B. So, here first we need to discuss about all the forces acting in the situation shown. So, let's have a look on this figure where we can see block A will have a tendency to go down due to its weight, but here the friction is the force which is mu n2 in limiting condition which will balance its weight. So, this mu n2 will act on block B in opposite direction where n2 is the normal reaction I can take between blocks A and B. If n1 is the normal reaction between block B and ground, we can say if the whole system will accelerate toward right, block B will experience a limiting friction mu n1. Now, in this situation, if I draw the free body diagram of block A, here you can see in case of block A, it is experiencing its weight mg in downward direction. A normal reaction n2 is acting toward left, and toward right the external force F is applied. In upward direction, the only force is friction, which is mu n2. And the block A, we consider it is moving toward right with acceleration A. And if we draw the free body diagram of block B, then here you can see block B is experiencing its weight in downward direction, which is 4mg. Upward direction is the normal reaction n1. Toward right, it will experience the normal reaction due to block A, which is n2. Toward left, it is experiencing the friction at bottom, which is mu n1. And this mu n2 will also act on block B in downward direction, which can be added here. And block B is also oscillating toward right with oscillation A as the two are moving together. So, if we write the equations of motion for these blocks, here you can see we can write for block A, this F minus N2 is equals to MA. In vertical direction, A is not a sliding, so we can write mu N2 is equals to MG. Say this is our first equation, this is the second equation. And here if we write the equations for free body diagram of block B, as it is moving toward right, we can write n2 minus mu n1 is equals to, its mass is 4m, so this can be written as 4ma. In vertical direction it is balanced, so we can write n1 is equals to 4mg plus, here mu n2 is already given as mg, so this can be taken as directly 5mg. So these are our equations 3 and 4. And solving these, we can calculate the value of F as here you can see from equation 1 directly I can write the value of F is equals to n2 plus ma. And if we substitute the value of n2 and n1 in equation 3, we can get the value of n2 directly here as mg by mu and a directly from this relation. So, here we can write from equation 3, the value of n2 I can substitute as mg by mu minus mu times n1 value is given as 5mg is equals to 4 times ma. So, in this equation, you can see the value of ma we are getting is this mg by 4 multiplied by, this can be written as 1 by mu minus 5 mu. This is the value of ma, and the value of n2 is mg by mu. So, this will give us the value of force, which is mg by mu plus the value of ma is, it can be written as mg by 4 mu we can take common, and this 1 minus 5 mu square. So this is the value of force which is required to be applied. Further, we can simplify it. We can take mg by mu common, and inside we are getting it as 1 plus this is 1 by 4 minus 5 by 4 mu square. This is the final result we can write. Further, if you wish, you can simplify this. The value of force at which the block A does not slide on the rough vertical surface of block B.